generally, especially if there are few errors, will be grossly overdetermined system. Which solution do we take? It doesn't matter. Any solution will produce P correctly when you divide P of x by E of x. Yes?
But if there's no solution to the system, do you just trash the message?
Because if there were too many errors. So, just using this redundancy to push things so that you see, this is true without you knowing, also for I's that are correctly transmitted and for those that were not correctly transmitted. So you don't have to know which ones are wrong, which ones are not. Because for as long as this equation is satisfied for all I, when you divide Q by E, obtained by solving these equations, picking any solution whatsoever, Q divided by E will produce the correct P. So it's really, please read it. This is so important algorithm, and it shows a beautiful design principle. Now, there is another slight problem. The problem is, if you have a dust particle on your CD, you are not going to injure 28 out of 256 symbols. You are going to injure a large number of consecutive, right? Similarly, if you have lightning strike, boom, which means the error comes in bursts. And this cannot, even if you have small fraction of errors, but they are concentrated, you will not be able to read the message. How is this solved? In an ingenious way. Instead of transmitting each word, say it's a byte, you will transmit first bit of the first word, first bit of the second word, all the way to first bit of, say, 10,000th word, then second bit of the first, second bit. So now if you have a burst error, it will kill second bits in large number of words, but each word will be injured on one bit only. You see the trick? So you simply spread the message over a long time by interleaving it with other messages, and if you have a burst error, only a few bits can be scrambled for each.
But there's the problem, the receiver have to buffer all the message.
Yes, that's true. Yeah. But you know, this is 256, it's, so the buffer is, of course, depends how big is the buffer, but we are talking about kilobytes of buffering. Yes. Well, there is no free lunch, you know. But this made such a, you know, such a, because now you could operate very close to information. You see, so to avoid confusion, if this is the true symbol, you would have to make sure that you never cross from this circle into that circle. But this means that you will have to be very tight about the true values. Now, you can actually be much larger because you can afford significant probability, 28 over 256, to go into other guy's domain and still correctly. So these symbols can be much tighter spaced for the same signal to noise ratio. And bandwidth is equal to what? What is bandwidth equal to in real life? To a lot of money. Right? If you can transmit, you can have, you know, 10 times as many mobile phone users. This just, and for that reason, the telecom companies tried to sabotage the patent of this little trick, claiming that math cannot be patented, right? But it is not math that is patent, it's the process that is patented. So they started a scare campaign, sending people emails that, in fact, some people are trying to patent math, and if you want to do science, you will have to pay royalty to make a citation, which was, of course, complete bullshit. Right? Because they simply didn't want to make poor Berlekamp and Welch rich people. But at the end, the US court correctly ruled that this is a perfectly valid... because why do people think? Because people think that only CEOs should become rich and the bloody engineers should sweat for nothing, right? That's the logic behind this. You know, it's only this incestuous club of the executive. Oh, I had better stop.